Hey guys, so while Grandpa's working on Grandma's car today, I'm gonna make a video for you guys. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna grab one of these small logs, and we can just do a quick cutting on the Woodmizer. I'm not gonna do anything real big. Do this small one right here. I'm thinking the one that my fingers are on top of. Maybe I'll do that one. One of these two. I'm going to do one of these, and we'll see what we can get out of it. So you guys are going to see that. I'm going to load it up quick, and we can get this. You guys can see me load this up. Alrighty guys, so loaded it up. I'm gonna straighten it out and move it up more. And then we'll see what we got. I just want to get it up to this one right here. There we go, now we're good. Alright, so now I got the lug where I want it. Now, I'm gonna grab the tape and I'm gonna see what I got. Alright guys, so I just pulled the Woodmizer out and I measured the lug. So I got a 9-inch lug. And that means I should get a 6.5-inch cant. I'm probably not going to. Just because not at the other end. The other end's not quite 9 inches, it's like 8.75. So I'm probably gonna get a 6-inch cant out of this. So it'll just be a quick little log to cut up. All right, so I'm gonna let this warm up for about 2 minutes, and then I'll come back and I'll cut this up. Alright guys, so it's been warming up for a minute now. What I actually did was I checked it with the metal detector. So it looks good. Now we're going to do our cut. I have the 6 inches I need right here now. So now I'm going to take the log and I'm going to roll it and I'm going to cut the next side. They're all good, they're not going to get hit by the blade. I will cut this up. so now I have my 5-inch cant, so now I'm going to cut one body out of them, because that's what Grandpa wants, and then I'm going to put them in the kiln. Alright guys, I'll show you one of the pieces quick, the one that's laying over here, so you guys can see. So this is a maple, it was just a small one, but it's very nice. So I'm going to open up the kiln quick, let's see what it is in there right now. 110. Yeah, you're looking forward to being in there. Alright guys, so the camera battery died again. The one that I got earlier must not have been that good charged. But anyway, I'm letting this open for a minute. It's 110 in here. The humidity is at like 35, oh that's 40 right there. It's pretty humid. So I did the math. I roughly cut 3.5 board feet per board, so that's 1, 2, 3, 4. Four boards that I got, so. And it was a good educational thing for me to cut it by myself, so. So I got that. They look very nice, and our cherry looks nicer every single time we look at it. That's the cherry down there. You can see how nice that looks. So. But some of the stuff on the top's warping pretty bad. Otherwise, that's it for this video. I gotta clean up these flitches, which won't take that long. I'll clean them up and then I'll throw them away. I'll take them over to the fire pile or wherever I want to put them. Our neighbor usually likes to take these off of us. So, alright, thank you guys for watching. Don't forget to like the video. Don't forget to comment anything you guys would like to comment, any questions or anything. I'd like to see them. And don't forget to subscribe as well. And we'll see you guys next time. Have a good one. Bye.
Hey guys, if you remember, there were two big holes in here. That's the panel that I formed. I'm about to weld it in place. Needs a little bit of adjustment yet, and then I'll weld it.